he must be good.
Kind of a surprise in the initial heats. Israel had the fastest time out of their heat, so keep an eye on that boat in lane 5. The favorites, based on pre-Sydney, lane 3, Great Britain, lane 6, Norway. And keep in mind, no boat has yet qualified for the finals. And only 3 boats out of this race will go to the finals. For the rest, their Olympics are over.
Well, Knut Holmann is off to a very fast start there in lane 6. He's the 1992 silver medalist, 1996 gold medalist. He's the favorite in this event.
And he had the 4th fastest time out of his heat. Hopes to be one of the 3 to advance. 1,000 meters will get a split at the 500 meter mark.
In the K-1 event, it's very important that you get out to a very fast start, establish your pace, and then finish strong. Right here, you can see that Knut Holmann is very relaxed and very solid out in the lead.
Tim Brabants in lane 3, third in his heat, representing Great Britain. He was 6th at the 99 World Championships. He has moved up there into second place.
Gary, I talked to Trevor Hunter, Tim's coach, earlier, and he is very impressed with the amount of endurance that Tim has.
And Holmann, taking the early lead, would like to be one of those boats to jump out early. He likes to gain the lead, maintain it, not one of those to try and pace in a second or third place and make a sprint.
Knut is very experienced. He's been doing this for a long time. At 32 years of age, he knows what it takes, this being his 4th Olympics.
And in lane 6, Holmann continues with the edge as they come to the 500 meter mark. Still a good pack of boats, though, with the full 9 complements racing here in the first of 3 semis, with Norway, Great Britain, and Israel the top 3.
Well, Michael Kolganov from Israel is really from Uzbekistan, and he immigrated to Israel and trains on the Sea of Galilee.
Interesting. They've been able to put together a pretty good group of paddlers and rowers as a result of those who have gone to Israel from other countries.
But really, when the Iron Curtain broke up, it really opened up things for Israel. Athletes were allowed to move there.
Norway still on top, though, at both lengths lead now. Brabants of Great Britain in lane 3 is in second place, but a battle with Israel in lane 5, and next to him, Roland Kökény in lane 4.
But right now, with only 3 boats out of this heat going to the finals, those second, third, and fourth boats are almost in a dead heat.
And you're in the final 250 meters of this race now. Still a pretty good lead for Norway and Holmann, but look at the battle. Only 2 of these boats are going to move on. Great Britain, Hungary, and Israel. Right now, too close to call here. They've got a sprint to the finish, and Kolkenny in lane 4 trying to catch up.
At this point in the race, everything is burning. Your forearms, your biceps, and your back. Everything's starting to hurt. Lactic acid's in full tilt. Right now, there is a lot of pain in these athletes.
They're closing in on the finish line. Holmann of Norway continues with that lead by a boat's length, but this battle for second, Great Britain, Israel, and Hungary are all right there as they come to the finish line.
And Kolganov, the Israeli, starting to put on a strong kick.
And the horn will go off as they cross the line at the finish. Norway first, Great Britain second, Israel third, and Hungary finishes fourth.
Great race by Knut. He was in control the whole way, obviously very experienced. Disappointment from the Hungarian.
That close, that far, to finish fourth in this race means it's done. But Great Britain and Israel, the other 2 boats along with Norway, to move on. What a finish.
Amazing. The Hungarian held on until right near the end, then he couldn't be in.
About this time, 0.016 seconds is all that separated Hungary from third place.
And Hungary won't have a boat in the final of the men's K1 1000.
Disappointing. Looks over, sees the time, realizes where he finished. Only 3 boats can go. They will be Norway, Great Britain.